In 2005, Ellen Johnson Sirleaf became Liberia's president in what was described as the country's most democratic election in decades. Now in her second term, I asked the president to reflect on what challenges remain for Liberia.
Liberia has a fractured history in terms of the population and a coup d'etat and, you know, two decades of war exacerbated the cleavage that have existed in the country for all this time. Recently, attempts through trying to rebuild a former national identity has come through our Vision 2030, in which views of everybody, how do you unify, how do you reconcile, how do you project, you know, a national image, it comes through that. The implementation of that vision is still underway and has not yet been achieved, but the fundamentals and the roadmap for achieving that is in place through this very rigorous consultative process. And so I hope that we'll be able to implement that over the several years of our effort.
Two decades of civil war forced many Liberians abroad, not just to neighboring African states, but further afield to the United States and Europe. How important is their return?
Diaspora is a very important element of our progress. For one thing, their remittances to the country are substantial to support their family, their institutions, their causes. We also need that a repatriation of the skills that have resided in the diaspora. And there is a movement of return, but not yet to the place where we can say we have a critical mass of skills and trained professionals to be able to manage the economy properly. But we believe that as our own conditions improve, you know, better health services, better educational services, better incentives for those who will return, that will begin to attract more and more. We're setting up a diaspora office in the presidency to make sure that they have a vehicle for continuing interaction, sharing of ideas, resolving issues, and planning for their return. So the diaspora is, you know, for us is our 16th county, where our political subdivision, that's our 16th political subdivision that's residing out there in the United States and in Europe.
The United Nations mission in Liberia began in 2003. Now, more than a decade later, it's begun a drawdown of its troops. It's estimated its military mission will be over by late next year.
UNMIL has been a very strong and important partner. We would not have been able to achieve the 10 years of peace without UNMIL support. In effect, the stability of the nation has to a large extent rested on them. Because our army was new, our security sector still under reform, not yet in the have all that they need to take full responsibility for our security, so they've been very important. We've worked on a transition program, and we feel fairly confident that we will be able to assume those responsibilities as we have to. It has to be a national responsibility. But we want to make sure that that transition takes into account the constraints we face and have enough flexibility for adjustments, and that's what the Security Council is working with us on. But we know also that the time will come when UNMIL will have to go and we'll have to assume full responsibility, and we're working toward that.